Hey everybody, welcome back to the Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork, and I'm Dr. Darryl L. Jones, the Senior Pastor of Champions for Christ Christian Church. Thank you so much for tuning in to Champions for Christ Christian Church Bookwork. Well, if you work the book will work. And today on the Bookwork, I want to talk about being under attack. Have you ever felt like you was under attack for trying to do what was right? Trying to practice your Christian faith, trying to live the life that God had purposed for you to live. Today, we are under attack. You know, growing up, I remember hearing about the Christian community being under attack, but I always thought that was back long time ago. I always thought it was, you know, biblical times, somewhere way far away from here. Somewhere like over across seas, somewhere over in some of these other countries that we probably don't visit too often. But how many of you know that we are under attack here in our own homes? Do you know that there are groups whose major purpose is to attack the Christian, attack the things that we say, attack the things that we believe in, and attack our lifestyle, the way we try to live according to the purpose God intended for us to live according to His Word. That was a prayer given, and these are the words of the prayer. Lord, we thank you for this day. Father, for this opportunity as a group. Father, we thank you for the movement of God that has put us in a place to be in charge. We thank you for each person here, each family. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Those were the words that was prayed by head football coach Deion Sanders of the University of Colorado. And there was this atheist group. And I won't even identify who they were because I just won't identify who they were. But there was this atheist group who sent a letter to the chancellor of the university system of Colorado, frustrated that they are allowing this man of God, this man of faith, to lead prayers because they said that that's a violation of the Constitution and it's violating the separation of state and church. Now, I understand that we have to uphold the Constitution. I understand that as an American citizen, and I understand that as one with the right to vote on the constitutional matters. But, you know, it just amazed me how they want prayer when it's convenient. And I'm talking about the atheist group because, you know, it's not like they don't pray. They don't utter words that are prayer-like. But for some reason, whenever someone is popular doing something of faith, it seems like it gets attacked. And you don't even have to be popular. You could be just you could just be me on your job, or you could be you on your job, or it could just be anything. But it's amazing how they always want to go after something popular. All these self-interest groups. But anyway, this atheist group attacking Deion Sanders. They're attacking the church. They're attacking us and want to silence us. You know, they have this cancel culture already that I will talk about in another message. But this here atheist group want to silence a man of God from praying. They say he led prayers. And there are some people who are not Christians and they felt uncomfortable. But they couldn't find nobody to step up and say it was them. So I don't know how they found out about it. And that don't really matter. But what matters is prayer is important. The Bible says that man should pray without ceasing. And the Bible also tells us when two or three of us come together, touch and agree in prayer, the Lord will be with us in the midst of us. So we who are Christians, we know that we're supposed to always pray. And yes, there might be times that you might have to pray silently. There might be times that you might have to pray in thought. But we're supposed to always be praying. And, you know, I'm not sure what's going to happen with Coach Deion Primetime Sanders. But I do know that he's a man of faith based off of all that I know about him. And I'm sure there's a whole lot more to know about him that I might not know. But I know enough to feel and believe that he is a man of faith. And if you are a woman or a man of faith and you're in an environment where it might not be to your advantage to pray openly, There are restrooms, there are break rooms. You could pray at your desk, you could pray in your car, you could pray. You know, there are ways around praying. And I know and I understand as a Christian that we are to, we're supposed to support the laws of the land. And I believe that. But I also find it hypocritical for these same group when there are shootings on campuses. Then they want to come and get everybody together and have candlelight visuals. When something happens, they want to get mental therapists to come in and talk to people and counsel people. I appreciate mental therapists. I appreciate mental awareness and mental health. I know the importance of it. And combined with prayer, it could be powerful. But nothing takes the place of prayer. And nothing takes the place of a woman or a man of faith to pray in a time of need, in a time of want, or in a time such as this. You should always pray. So I just wanted to stop by and encourage all of us, encourage not only just Champions for Christ, but everybody who will hear this on social media, everybody that knows me, know that I believe that we as men and women, especially those of us who belong to the Christian community, we should always pray. Jesus prayed. Jesus taught his disciples to pray. And we teach our disciples today how to pray and the importance and power of prayer. So understand this. I don't get too frustrated often, especially to the point where I want to communicate it publicly. But that bothered me. Here it is, you know, all this stuff going on in the world that we can address. You want to address a man leading a team of young men and other men in prayer. Do better. Be better on purpose, you atheist group. And you know, I respect you, but respect us as well. Thank you so much for tuning in to Champions for Christ Christian Church Book Work. Well, if you work the book will work. You can join us every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock a.m. on Facebook Live. That's every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock a.m. on Facebook Live. Go to our website, www.c4cchurch.com. Email us at c4cchurch@gmail.com for a prayer request. Anything that you have that you feel like, if you want to know more about how to be working towards your purpose in God, living on purpose, being the person that God called you to be, send us an email. Communicate with us. Well, until we're together again, we are Champions for Christ. Peace.